How's it going? Adam Drake here, and today I'm going to show you how I balance my J-Concepts tires and share a little bit of information about why it's important to balance your tires. In most cases with J-Concepts buggy tires, there requires very little or even no balancing at all. But because of the insert, the tire, the wheel, there can be a little bit of variance from time to time to where the tire can be a little bit out of balance. With some manufacturers, this is a lot more important because the tires are not as consistent and do not come balanced as well after you mount them. So I actually went through a couple sets of tires. Again, with buggy, this isn't super critical because the buggy tires are usually very good right out of the box, but from time to time you will get one that's a little off. It's more beneficial, I would say, on truck because you have a larger tire, larger insert, larger wheel. There's more of a chance of it being slightly out of balance. And again, with some manufacturers, you'll see the trucks sitting on the car stand and the wheels vibrating, almost wanting to fall off the starter box. So first, I'm gonna go through and just show you the tools that I use. I have just a little handheld tire balancer. You wanna make sure whether you're using a handheld tire balancer or the actual like balancing station that the bearings are sprayed out and oiled to where they're really free. This should just spin super easy. That way you're able to get a more accurate and consistent setup. And then I just have some balancing clay. You can get this through Amazon. You can get it at a craft store. Basically, you're just needing something that has some weight to it to be able to kind of counterweight and balance out the tire. So we'll go ahead and I actually mount this onto the handheld balancer backwards from the way that it's supposed to. It actually has the hex to where this is flipped, but then it's a little bit more difficult to get in there to mark the wheel and also to balance the tire. So you can see here, when I just let the tire sit, it naturally just rocks back and forth just slightly. And what you'll wanna do is wait, like I just bumped it on the backside with my finger on accident, but you'll wait until that settles, take a Sharpie. And what this is telling me is that on the bottom side, it's a little bit heavy. So I'm gonna mark directly up at the very top. So that's where I know where I need to put my balancing clay. Now, I don't worry so much about it being just absolutely perfect, like not rocking back and forth at all. I go ahead, I mark the wheel so I know where I'm gonna need to add a little bit of the clay. But what I'll also do is make sure I hold the balancer sturdy and I'll just give it a good spin. And you can see that there is just a little bit of vibration. Probably wouldn't be too much of a concern, especially knowing sometimes dirt will get in the wheel and adjust the balance as well. But I wanna make sure that these are as good as they can be. So I'm gonna go ahead, peel off just a little pinch of that clay. I'm gonna stick it to the wheel where I have the rim marked. I'm gonna let it go and then see if that mark that I marked is still at the top. It's not. It's actually at the bottom. So that means I added a little bit too much of the balancing clay. So I'm gonna just pick out a little bit, check it, see where it settles. My mark is still at the top, so it's telling me that it's still a little bit heavy on the bottom, but I'm gonna go ahead and just give it a spin. It's much better than it was before, even though it wasn't that far out of balance before. So now I'm gonna just take an even smaller piece of clay put it towards the top where my mark is, give it a quick spin, and now it's basically perfect. Stop it and check it. And now you can see how slow the tire is turning. I'm gonna give it a little bump. It's not rocking back, it's basically staying. Now it just barely starts to rock back. And my mark is just off from the top center. So I'll go ahead and do that with, check the rest of these tires. And again, some tires you may not need to balance at all. This one actually is a little bit worse than that. So we'll do the same thing. Go ahead and mark the wheel. Take a slightly larger piece of the balancing clay because this one was a little bit more out of balance. Stick that in, give it a good spin. And then now, again, you may see a little bit of kind of run out, but the actual feeling in your hand is a dramatic difference. There's no vibration like there was before balancing that tire. So we'll go ahead and check these last two real quick. Again, you can see my fingers just shaking just a little bit. It's not bad. You could race with these tires, no problem, but the main reason for wanting to do this is it's just going to give the car a little bit smoother, more consistent acceleration, and it's also going to make the suspension components last a little bit longer. Because what's going on with, think if you have all four of those tires shaking and vibrating, it's shaking and vibrating the whole car. So again, just really quick, little piece of putty, that vibration and shake has gone away. And then now we'll do the fourth and final tire. This one's actually pretty good, just a little bit. So because there was very little vibration, I'm going to use a very little piece of the clay. I'm going to go just a little bit more. Let me check it. Actually, that piece was a little bit on the big side, too heavy. So there you go. So again, this is to make the car handle a little bit better, more consistent, make the acceleration a little bit smoother, and also to preserve and extend the life of your suspension components. If you have tires that are extremely out of balance, the whole car is kind of shaking and vibrating, and that's not going to be good for the handling or efficient for the overall running and acceleration of the vehicle. So super simple steps. You can get tire balancers from a lot of the popular companies on the market. J Concepts makes a really nice tire balancer. But this is just the steps that I use that you can use for yourself for 1/8 scale buggy and truggy balancing of your tires.